Hey Jackals, do you know what you can use to make videos even better? Any ideas? No? It's music! But do you know what the biggest issue is when it comes to music? It's licensing. I won't go into that, but I strongly suggest you listen to this podcast by Devin Nash. And the second issue is that you actually have to find the music that you want to use in your video project. So what you can do is to use something like BandLab to make your own music, which is what I did. Now let's get digital. So what is BandLab? It's a digital audio workstation, which means that you can make music with it. It's completely free, anything you make, you own. You can sell what you make by making albums, you can share the music for free, and if you want, you can also allow others to make changes to it. Like DaVinci Resolve, BandLab enables you to collaborate with others, and if music is something that you want to do, you can also make bands. And just to let you know, this video is not sponsored, I'm just showing you what's available to you, and it's what I use to make my music, because it's all I need. When you make an account and log in, you'll most likely land on the feed page. So you have your stats, the projects that you made, and the social media for music. Some music you can only play, but others that have this option, you can also fork, which means that you can edit the music. And I'll show you that in a bit. Now the Explorer page is self-explanatory. And then you have the library. You have your own projects, a bunch of them. And you can see I already clicked on the fork, which is this music that someone else made. Then you have the album page, where you can actually sell the music that you make. I made a test album, but with no music inside. Then you have the collections, which are the playlists. And the bands and communities. But now let's get to actually making the music. If you're in library projects, you can click on the new project, you can click on the create, or you can click on one of the existing projects. I'll select this one. It shows up like this. You can click the play button. And then you can click open in mix editor. So let's do that. This can take some time to load up, but if you have a new project, this will be instantaneous. So you can hold Ctrl and use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. You can see what they used. But let's just make a quick new project. So you can see the actual screen. So you can use instruments, drum machines, voice by recording your own voice with the microphone. Guitar, bass, you can import audio, and you can pro samples. What I use, because I'm not a musician, I just use samples. I suggest you decide on the mood that you want the music to have. Maybe you want a jazzy one, let's see what comes up. Type in jazz. You can then listen to the music to get a feeling for it. This one sounds like an upbeat one, so let's go with this one. Just click on it, and you have a bunch of sound samples that you can use. You can now also preview them. As you can see, this one has drums, percussion, bass, piano, guitar, and some samples. So let's say I want to go with this one. You just click and drag it in. So I've used number 3, and you can just go with all of the 3s. Now let's take a listen what this sounds like. That doesn't sound good, but I'm only showing you how it's done. Let's say that you want to increase all of these ones in the duration. What you can do is to just click on it and drag the top one. If you wanted to make it short, let's say to this point, drag the bottom one. You can of course also copy it. Move the playhead and paste it. Depending on which track is selected, it's going to be pasted in that place. If you double click on a sample, the editor will open up and you can adjust the beginning and the ending to ease in and out. What you can also do in the editor is to change the shift. change the speed of the playback so you can slow it down or speed it up, and you can also reverse it. You can also mute the tracks that you don't want to include in the final music, and if you just want to listen to what you've made, like one piece of the track, you can click solo. And now only this one is playing. You can add some effects to this. Let's say this one. Now we have some jazz going on. Let's see, do we have anything with ska, pop, maybe something with pop. Maybe this one, so you can open this one and you can mix and match. Of course, this doesn't mean that this will sound great, but you can do this. Definitely doesn't sound good, but you can do first part jazzy, second part something else, and then go back to the jazzy one. But what a music can also have is voice. So you can record yourself if you have a microphone plugged in, or you can use something in the voice packs. So you can type in voice, or go under loops and type voice here. And then under the instruments, we don't want that, we want voices. What I suggest to do at least once, if the automatic save doesn't work, and also name the project, is to click on save. And then when you finish with the music, you can publish it, so that others can listen to it. But if you don't want that, you can go to the file and download. You can download each individual track. I have 7, 8 here. Or you can download Mixdown. It'll take some time to do this. And when it's done, you can download it as an MP3 of different quality or as a WAV file. Now let's go back to the library. We have this one. I'll delete the project because I don't want it. And as you can see, all of my projects are locked, meaning you can't listen to them. But this one is the last one that I've made, and I'll open it up for you so you can listen to it. So to publish it from the library, click on the project. Go to publish. You can type in a description. Explicit content. No, it's not an explicit content. It will be public. Oh, what is this one? Something chilly. I'll just do chill vibes. So I'll leave a download to this one. And if you want to make it private again, just click on the three dots and make private. And that is a quick overview on how to make music in BandLab. Now is BandLab the best? I have no idea. But the comparison that I got is that Ableton, or is it Ableton? Let's go with Ableton. Is that Ableton Live versus BandLab is like comparing Photoshop to Canva. Now the comparison might be valid, but BandLab is free and Ableton is paid. If you would like to see how I make music in BandLab, give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more DaVinci Resolve content, and hit the bell notification icon so you don't miss my next video. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackals, keep it digital.